Today we're going to be talking about why injuries occur in sport, and specifically we're going to go through some of the injury etiology models that have been published in the literature. So before we go any further, let's define what we mean when we say etiology. Depending on whether you speak British or American British language will determine whether you spell it AE as in Britain or just with the E as in American English. This is defined that it is the study of the cause of a disease. And of course, in this case, we are seeing the disease as injury. So for this video, I'm going to go through a blog post that I wrote a number of years ago, and I'll put the link below so that you can refer back to it at any point. So the post is called Understanding the Evolution of Injury Etiology Models, and we'll go through each now. One of the key papers, perhaps not so much on injury etiology, not so much on the causation, but the Van Mechelen 1992 model of prevention of sports injuries. So this was one of the first papers to present a framework to try and allow researchers to establish the effectiveness of an intervention that tried to prevent injuries. The first step being understanding the extent of the injury problem. Based on those injuries, understand the etiology, so what might cause those injuries, and specifically the mechanisms. And based on that understanding, then bring in a so-called preventative measure, and then repeat step one by once again quantifying and comparing your injury problem. This was a real keystone paper that provided researchers with this framework to start exploring injuries and how we might reduce them. And in 1994, Dr. Moisa published his first injury etiology model by introducing this multifactorial concept. So again, as far back as 1994, highlighting the importance of many risk factors to causing injury. And this model proposed that we have athletes who have different levels of being predisposed to injury by their intrinsic risk factors, such as age, previous injury being a really key one, perhaps the most influential risk factor, and these internal risk factors can predispose an athlete. It is then exposure to external risk factors that can make the athlete susceptible. And then it is a specific inciting event that would cause injury. And this model is still very key, as we will see, to some of the models that have come since. This model perhaps takes a little bit more of a biomechanical focus, making the point around mechanical load in terms of tissue tolerance. And this is perhaps sometimes where we are a bit reductionist in our current discussions around training load, in terms of load tolerance, but also how that differs between different tissue types. So as you can see here in this paper, McIntosh states that injury results from a transfer of energy to the tissue, with the body's response dependent on different factors depending on the tissue type. Injury prevention methods should focus on either reducing loads experienced by the body and or increasing load tolerance of the body. 2005, Professor Robar combined the Moisa's model along with McIntosh's biomechanical model into this model around prevention. So we see still this key core of the predisposed athlete based on the internal risk factors, which in this paper they expanded the discussion of what these could be. They expanded the discussion around external risk factors, be it sports factors, equipment, environment, But then also incorporated some of McIntosh's biomechanical themes to expand the discussion around the inciting of. So that event could be, as they list here, a playing situation. It could be either the athlete's behavior or movement or an opponent, as well as these biomechanical factors, either across the whole body or a specific part. A couple of years later, Dr. Moisa published a new model, and this was really a key model. It was the first time that the dynamic nature of injuries was specifically mentioned in one of these models. So this recursive nature that injury risk is constantly changing because athletes don't just train or play once and then that's over. So here is a copy of the dynamic and recursive model that Dr. Moisa published in 2007. Again, we see the internal risk factors predisposing an athlete, and then it's exposure to external risk factors that can make them susceptible. Here is where that dynamic nature is brought in, because there are multiple events and often there are exposures to risk factors and sport that do not lead to injury. However, if there is an inciting event, then that would lead to injury. But up to this point, none of these models that we've discussed specifically stated training load or workload within them. And so Johan Wind and Tim Gabbett then published their workload injury etiology model. We can still see the predisposed athlete, the susceptible athlete, and the inciting event. But the authors argued that workload is not an internal risk factor. It's not a characteristic of the athlete. It's not an environmental factor, which is what these external risk factors tend to be. They presented workload as the vehicle within which an athlete is exposed to the external risk factors. Obviously, if you don't train or play, if you don't have any workload, then you're not exposed to that risk. And so they describe this as the key vehicle within which athletes are exposed. And of course, this dynamic nature again, where there may be an injury or there may not be an injury. And importantly as well with this dynamic nature is the fact that workload itself can have an influence on the risk in a recursive nature, because the training stimulus is impacting their fitness status and also their fatigue status, which can be linked with these modifiable factors that then influence risk going forward. So far, we've looked at this purely from a physiological and biomechanical bias, but we should also mention the psychology stream. It's really interesting to consider the injury etiology models that psychology puts forward. This being one of the cornerstone models, Anderson and Williams. And here they put forward that injury can be a result of a poor stress response, so the body's inability to deal with the stress it is put under. But from a psychological aspect, whereby the body is cognitively appraising the stressor that it is being exposed to, and this is influencing their physiological and attentional responses, which may or may not lead to injury. So in more recent times, we're seeing this more holistic approach to injury causation through the introduction of a complex systems approach. An absolute must-read paper on this topic was by Natalia Bittencourt and colleagues in 2016, and highlighting moving from risk factor identification from an isolated perspective to injury pattern recognition. So here in this paper, they propose this model whereby the risk factors are in what they describe here as a web of determinants. And each of these are interacting with each other in, again, a dynamic way that is then determining the emergent pattern. But of course, as we know, there is a recursive loop. So this is both dynamic and recursive. And looking here then at the web of determinants, you can see different risk factors. And firstly, they have different connections between each other. So the thickness of the line representing how strong that interaction is. And also the thickness of the border of each risk factor itself determining the impact that is having. So in this case, here in the paper, they have A being a basketball, I believe it's stipulated as a male basketball player, and B being a female ballet dancer. So we can see there are different risk factors within each of their web of determinants with differing levels of importance and differing interactions between each other. So the complex systems approach really seems to be an area of interest right now in injury etiology. I think it's important to finish on this quote that all models are wrong, but some are useful. So these models are proposing how injuries may occur within the body. Based on that is how we can start to bring in our injury prevention or perhaps injury risk minimization strategies. But always remember that injury is dynamic, recursive, and complex.